Yo, what is up, dudes? My name is Zoom, and welcome. We're going on a road trip right now to Indiana. Where are we going? Fort Wayne?
Yep.
Or is that the other place that we were going to?
Yep, Fort Wayne.
I don't know, but it's Monday, and I'm going to school. It's 5:14 right now. In the morning, as you can see, it's pitch black outside. And there's my bass.
Come on, baby, let's go. We gotta go.
And I got a EST that is for sale. $40. Because I got that up there. It's a new car that I got. Well, I traded my Nitro RC car for that. That one's electric, not gas. Because I was trying to sell the gas, but gas cars are hard to sell. Not a lot of people are looking for gas. Electric is way easier to sell. So I might get a brushless system for that and keep it or sell it. I don't know. Okay, see you on the road.
Want to stay upstairs or no?
Yeah.
Check, 1, 2.
Yeah.
I think you're gonna have to look
at the high check, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. Check, 1, 2. This is a podium mic check. Check, 1, 2, 3, 4. Check, 1, 2. Podium mic check. Check. Check, Fort Wayne, Indiana. Check, 1, 2. Check, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce recording artist and Indiana University graduate, Mark Crowder, to sing our national anthem.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly. That our flag was still there. Oh. say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Until this president, he was the best president of my lifetime. Tonight, the president of the United States is coming right back here to Northeast Indiana, and I can't wait to hear from Donald J. Trump. How about you? Now, how many of you knew that back in 2001, the company that I used to work for, Hagerman Construction, you ever heard of them?
Yep.
They raised the roof on this building. Do you know that? And tonight, President Trump is going to raise it even higher. Now, this is Memorial Coliseum, for those of you that didn't know that, here in Allen County, Fort Wayne, Indiana. This is where we memorialize our heroes who have served our great country in uniform. So right now, if you are a veteran of the United States of America, will you raise your hand so we can thank you for your service?
Thank you.
like to be in Indiana. We had a big victory here not so long ago. Big victory.
Big one.
A big one. And I'm thrilled to be back in the heartland. And you want to see something special?
Yeah.
Take a look outside at the thousands and thousands of people that wanted to get inside. You got lucky. This is an incredible time for America. Jobs are soaring, wages are rising, optimism is skyrocketing, and more Americans are working today than ever before in our history. Tomorrow, the people of Indiana are going to send Mike Braun to the U.S. Senate to keep America's economic boom surging full speed ahead. He's a great guy, very successful guy, wonderful guy. Nobody knows he went to Harvard Business School and did well. I shouldn't mention Harvard, but I have to because at least it shows he has very high aptitude tests, right? And that's, you know, that's okay. That's a good thing. He's a smart guy, and he's a great guy, and he loves the people of Indiana. He loves Indiana. Mike Braun. Republicans have created the best economy in the history of our country. This is the single best economy in the history of our great country. And it's the hottest jobs market on the planet Earth. But everything we have achieved is at stake tomorrow. Everything. Because they can take it apart just as fast as we built it. But I don't think that's going to happen based on what I'm seeing all over. If the radical Democrats take power, they will take a wrecking ball to our economy and to the future of our country. When you enter the voting booth on Tuesday, you will be making a simple choice. A vote for Republicans is a vote to continue our extraordinary prosperity. You know the funny thing about this stuff, though? There's a guy who's a weak person with a weak voice. Nobody hears him. But our guys are all going crazy like this. Our guys actually make the disturbance, but that's okay. We love our guys, like you.
So that was pretty fun. I'm kind of mad that my phone ran out of battery after that. Few shots. I got my phone literally died after that one clip where they were like trying to kicking that one guy out. She was screaming, like, F you, Trump, or something. So, yeah. My phone, literally, I don't remember how much it was at, but... I mean, it was pretty fun. It was pretty fun. I got this. Good hat. Well, my brother got one, too. Make America Great Again. And then, as you can see, I got these little posters. People were hanging them up. They're like, ah! And throw them all around. And when I was trying to record him, the Trump coming out, the some guy was like holding this thing up. So, well, I got Keep America Great, and then promises made, promises kept. So yeah, I got those things. Oh, and can't forget about the shirt, Trump, Make America Great. See, I would wear that to school, but I'd probably get beat up. but yeah, so that was pretty fun. The one thing that I don't like is the waiting time. We were outside. I think we were waiting in that line since from 9. We got there at 9, and then we were coming back. Or no, we came there at 9, at 9 in the morning. We made it. We left at 4, and we made it at 9. And I think we waited in line for 4 hours, something like that. I think they started opening the doors at 2 o'clock. It was regularly scheduled to open at 3:30, the doors to open, but they opened at 2:30 because it was super cold outside, man. And when we finally went in, we went into that big venue or stadium or whatever. It was pretty cool. That place was big. Doesn't look that big, but when all the people were coming in and when he first walked out on the stage, dude, everyone went crazy, and that thing was so loud when the guy was singing the anthem. That was literally so loud. It doesn't sound that loud, but man, it was loud in there. The vibes were good. That was real fun. But then when we were in the venue, see, I didn't really care about it, the waiting this time, because when we made it in the venue, I think it was like 3 o'clock, because we bought the hat and the shirt. And once we made it in, it was 3 o'clock. It took us like 30 minutes because there's a pretty big line at the store. So when we finally made it in, we sat down, and there wasn't still a lot of people, but when we were walking, we saw there was windows outside, and we saw all the people still waiting. From our car all the way in the back, if you can see in the beginning of the clip where I was like, we made it, we here, boys. Literally, the line was farther than our car, which was so surprising. There were so many people. I think there was, I don't know, like, what, 3,000 people in that one stadium? Maybe less. I don't know how much people were actually in there. About around 3,000. And there was another 3,000 sitting outside listening to them. So that was pretty fun. But the waiting time inside the stadium was pretty long. We went in there at 3 o'clock and we had to wait there until 6. And then he finally came and then we did all that. But man, I'm so mad that freaking phone died. I got some pretty cool shots, but I wish I could have got more, but, whatever. It was fun. So, anyways, I know most of you don't like Trump. I mean, I wouldn't say I love him. I respect him. He's a good president. Honestly, my opinion, you can have your opinions. I know I'm gonna have so many dislikes on this video, hate comments and all that stuff, but I mean, you can have your opinion. I'm not saying that Hillary Clinton's bad. I mean, fuck, you could have voted for her. I'm saying my opinion. If you don't like it, it's fine. Dislike, comment, whatever you want. It's your opinion. Free country, your opinion. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. And I hope you enjoyed. Have a good one. Bye-bye.